In this video, you will learn practical tips on feeding, the energy requirements to maximize milk production and to have good fertility, and lots more. My name is Peter Edmondson. I'm a veterinarian who has been working with small-scale dairy farmers in Africa for many years. A dairy cow should be well fed so that she can be healthy, produce a lot of milk, and have good fertility, giving birth to a calf every year. The cow needs a balanced diet which contains energy, protein, fiber, vitamins, minerals, and the most important nutrient, which is water. Always make sure that the cow has fresh, clean water at all times. See my YouTube video, Water for Cattle. A cow should have good quality feed available 24 hours a day. She will eat 10 to 12 times a day for a total of about 5 hours. The cow will smell and taste her food and will always eat the fresh and sweet food first. She will leave any feed that is not appetizing unless there is nothing else to eat. Cows prefer to eat at ground level. It is important that cows can eat comfortably. The feed trough must be cleaned out regularly so that food does not go moldy and spoil, and to minimize food waste. The cow is a ruminant and has 4 stomachs. When a cow eats, the food is first chewed for a short period of time and then swallowed when it enters the rumen, the largest and first stomach. The food from the rumen is regurgitated later when it is intensively chewed to break down the fiber. This is called ruminating or chewing the cud. The cow will spend 10 to 12 hours a day ruminating. Cows need to eat good quality fiber for successful rumination. The rumen contains between 100 and 150 liters of liquid. It contains billions of microbes which break down the feed and digest the food that the cow has eaten. Rumen microbes like stable conditions and do not like sudden feed changes. Any changes to feed should be made gradually. A cow can eat 2 types of feed, forage and high energy or hard feed. Forage is fresh grass, hay or silage and fills the rumen. Fiber slows down the passage of food in the rumen and is essential for efficient digestion. Examples of high energy or hard feed are maize meal, spent grains, rice bran, and madea in Malawi. These are most commonly fed when cows are being milked. It is important to ensure that there are adequate minerals and vitamins, which are essential for good health and for the body to function efficiently. These should be added to the food every day as recommended, especially at times when the feed quality is poor. Forage quality can vary significantly. In the rainy season, the nutritional quality of forage is high and very palatable. This forage is green and lush. Forage quality reduces significantly in the dry season, when it is stemmy and brown and far less palatable. Some farmers preserve forage and make hay or silage, which can be fed during the dry season when the forage quality has a low nutritional value. All animals need a basic amount of energy, which is called maintenance, to cover activities such as eating, digesting, thinking, and moving around. Let's look at how energy requirements for maintenance and milk production vary by stage of lactation. Let's take a 350 kilo Jersey Cross cow that is not milking and not pregnant. This cow needs to eat the amount of energy shown in the blue box every day for maintenance. Let's compare the previous cow to a similar sized cow that calved a week ago and is giving 12 litres of milk a day. The amount of energy required for maintenance remains the same, but this cow needs to eat more than double the amount of energy to be able to produce 12 litres of milk. You can see the importance of feeding lots of high energy feed if you want cows to milk well. This cow has calved 2 months and is at peak production, giving 18 litres of milk a day. The amount of energy for maintenance remains the same, but the amount of energy to produce 18 litres per day is extremely high. This cow needs to eat 3 times the amount of energy per day compared to maintenance. And the way that this is achieved is by feeding lots of high quality or high energy feed to the cow. If the cow doesn't get adequate energy, then milk production will start to drop. High energy intakes also improve fertility. If the cow does not eat enough energy, then she will not come on heat and she will not get pregnant. Milk yield reduces in later lactation, and so the cow needs less energy for milk production. Here we have a cow giving 6 litres of milk. The amount of energy required for maintenance remains the same, but the amount of energy required for milk production has reduced significantly compared to when she was giving a lot more milk. The cow will stop milking and will be dried off about 2 to 3 months before the next calving. Here we have a dry cow who is producing no milk. She still needs the same amount of energy for maintenance, but she requires extra energy to provide for the growing calf in late pregnancy. These examples highlight the need to feed the cow according to how much milk she is producing and stage of pregnancy. What we have seen in this video is that the energy needed for milk production is high. Feeding good quality or high energy feed gives a very good return on investment. Smallholder farmers have found that this is how cows give most milk. Some have cows giving 20 litres per day, and they get good fertility with a calf born every year. Milk production will drop if a cow does not get enough energy. Don't forget to supplement vitamins and minerals so the cow works efficiently, and feed good quality forage all year round. Thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, then please sign up for more. This video has been produced in association with the African Jersey Forum. It has been written and narrated by Peter Edmondson. It is an Otherwise production and part of a video series for small-scale dairy farmers. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel so you don't miss future videos.